Hello everyone, it's Rad. Welcome to my channel Rad Kutarot, and this is going to be a disclaimer that needs to stand in front of every video I do. So if you this is the first time you are here, welcome. If not, and should you wish to proceed, well, you can fast forward into the reading that it is ahead of this disclaimer. But as a disclaimer, I need to advise you that this is a general reading of the representative star sign, and for that reason, because tarot is very personal divination tool and does require narrative, which in personal readings appear to be your question or the situation that you are describing, the general reading may or may not resonate entirely with your situation. And if it resonates, that great. If it doesn't, I do apologize for that, but and I wish you the best, you know, with the situation that you're trying to cope with. But if you wish to proceed with the personal readings, or you wish to follow me on Facebook or on YouTube, you know, all of that, or visit my website, all of that is going to be written in the description, the box down below. And thank you for watching in advance. And now lay back and enjoy the video. All right, so this is going to be a Virgo Sun, Virgo Moon, and as well Virgo Rising. Weekly tarot reading, December 9th to December 15th, 2019. And bear with me just a couple of seconds, guys, to shuffle the tarot cards. And we can jump right into the spread. By the way, this is going to be a new spread. I've decided to change the things a little bit and to make it a little bit more chill at my end, because the elemental dignities, it's quite complex and kind of takes a bit of a toll on me. Anyway, so the first card here for the week for you, Virgo, is going to be the Wheel of Fortune, followed by the second one, which stands for the energies that are supporting the theme and the topic here. That is going to be the Knight of Wands, followed by the third one, which stands for the challenges that you will have to overcome. That is going to be the Five of Wands. Then it is the fourth one, which is the gifts and the blessings from the week. That will be the Three of Wands, followed by the fifth one, which stands for the how the people will gonna see you for throughout the week. That is going to be the Star card. The sixth card here, it is what you can do to help your goals. That is the Hierophant. The seventh card, it is what can hurt your goals, or in other words, what you should not do throughout this week. That is going to be the Ten of Pentacles. And the last one, it is the Guidance card. That will be the Magician card. All right. So it seems to be quite of an exciting week that we do have for you, Virgo. Now, the first two cards, which has to be interpreted together because they are pretty tightly related, are those two. So we do have the Wheel of Fortune as a topic, and the energy supporting the topic is the Knight of Wands. So it looks like that the week is going to be dappled with many surprises, many opportunities for you. Now, you have to take on the Wheel of Fortune. It is like it's a hurricane of options available and of opportunities, and you are in the eye of the storm, if you will. And this chaos that is going on around does not affect you in any way, but you get to choose which opportunity to go for. And that correlates with the energies a lot, because with those energies you have the luxury to experiment. You know, you try one thing, it doesn't work out, then you go for the other, it doesn't work out, or it may work out as well, you go for the third one, and so on and so forth. So very, very productive week is what you can have here to try out and to see, is it gonna work out for you, or is it not gonna work out for you, either in career or either in relationship wise. Now, so as we can see, this is going to be the week of the trial and error for you. But the thing here with those energies, it is that they quickly diminish. As productive they are, they, like said, they quickly diminish, abates. So as soon as you find out what works for you and what opportunities are for you to take on, you have to situate yourself or restrict yourself only into those kind of opportunities or ways of how to do things. Now, needless to say here, the potential of the week is immense. What I mean is that you are probably going to find out how to mesmerize the person you are interested in. You are going to find out, you know, how to be productive into your career, or how to and I'll be successful in a particular project. But once again, as soon as you find the right way through, you have to situate yourself in this way instead of continuously searching for another, because you are gonna burn out. So what is going to be the challenge here? That is going to be the five of wands. And as we said, surprises, they are not going to be all pleasant surprises. Now, the five of wands, it is the dynamic itself. So what I mean here, it is that there are going to be a lot of chores as well, alongside, you know, with the productive enterprises that are going to be offered to you throughout this week. And you're going to kind of like feel and find yourself, if you will, quite overwhelmed from all those activities. But on a plus side, the five of wands, it's a very good card reversing the course of the events. It will be challenging because it falls into the challenging position, but not impossible. So you can definitely attend into a situations in your life, either career wise or relationship wise, which things are going sour, and to fix that and to make it to improve instead to deteriorate. Once again, it's going to be challenging, but not impossible. Now, the next card here, it is about the gifts and the blessings that you are going to experience throughout this week. And that is the gifts and the blessings from the Tree of Wands. So the gift of the Tree of Wands, it is the stable patterns and the solid foundation that you are going to be able to establish throughout the week. And from there, you get to improve. Okay, from there you can use it as a milestone, as a checkpoint, as a trampoline, so you can skyrocket yourself in the future. Now, important thing, however, with the Tree of Wands, it's about as well challenging oneself. So you have to try to perform beyond your limitations or beyond your capabilities that you have self-imposed. Basically, the blessing here, it is that you are going to exceed your capabilities throughout this week, December 9th to December 15th. And it's kind of understandable. You're going to have so many things to taste from that will make you aware that you can simply go for more. You can be better, you know, and in general, you can achieve a greater goals than the original goals you have set in front of yourself. So the other card here is how people see you, and that is going to be the Star card. So people are seeing you as an individual with high standards, high morals, and as well high dreams and high hopes. Also as a very not reliable, but how do you say that someone is a very devoted, this is what I'm trying to say, a very devoted kind of individual that follows his goal and does not strain from it regardless what. That itself is going to make you as an example. So people are going to see you as an example. And also people will see you as a very gentle kind of an individual who is willing to help and who is worthy for the cumulative love, if you will, the unconditional love of the others, and support as well. The other card here refers to what you can do to help your goals, okay, or what is going to help your goals, and that is the Hierophant card. So few things can really help you. The first thing, it is that as with all situations, the Hierophant points that you should not try to reinvent the wheel. Whatever worked before for someone else is gonna work for you as well in regards to your goals, either business goals, romantic goals, it doesn't really matter. So canceling yourself with someone who is more successful at that stage than you in regards to your goals, it is what you should do, and it is what's gonna help you improve yourself in regards to the goals that you are chasing. Another thing, it is to take on the plights and the problems that you are facing in regards to your goals with a calm fashion, and instead of trying to be creative really and smart about it, why don't you try to resolve them as you use already existing methods to resolve those issues. The other card here represents what you should not do in order to chase your goals, or in other words, what is going to hurt your goals. That is the Ten of Pentacles, and actually a couple of things. One, it is the seclusion. It's like you close yourself within yourself, not allowing anybody to help you. That is one thing. And the other, so in other words, you may take throughout this week the dependency is bad thing, but actually throughout the week the dependency is codependency. So you are depending on someone and that someone is depending on you, therefore together you can be in use for one another. And the other thing here, it is about your unconditional trust. What I mean is that, you know, while to trust someone is a good thing, you should not give your trust away lightly, but instead you always first need to test the one that you want to give your trust at, because your trust may be betrayed. And the last card here for you, Virgo, it refers to the guidance that Tarot is offering, and that is going to be the Magician. Awesome card for guidance. It simply points that you are capable enough to reach your goals. On top of it, it does urges you to lean toward your personal, it's not independence, but sovereignty, I would say, and as well to use your communicational skills, because they're going to be amplified throughout this week. Learn new things, especially as we do have the Hierophant card here of what you can help you throughout, as you are going to cancel yourself, or you're going to have an opportunity to cancel yourself, or how you can achieve your goals, and that will allow you to learn a great deal of new things. And the last thing that the Magician is guiding you toward, it is determination. Whatever you do, you need to be convincing with it, or about it as well, so you can breed confidence into your followers. Because with the Magician, if you do all these things, you are gonna have followers. So that being said, Virgo, this was your weekly reading, December 9th to December 15th, 2019. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it, guys, and we're going to see each other next time. Until then, bye.